Party with your host David Lauser.
And that was some funky music. Well, let's say welcome to the DW playlist party, not DJ. I was told the proper title of this place. My name is David Lauser. See my name on the screen. And I am most noted for being a longtime drummer with Sammy Hagar, touring recording. Sammy and I met years ago. And this is really exciting. Like a lot of drummers, some of us started by accident, self-taught. We didn't know we were going to play. Some grew up in musical families and are educated. I'm slightly educated. Actually, I learned how to play by accident. I want to tell you a quick story. A friend of mine, I was cleaning his bedroom. His mother told us if we wanted to hang out, we'd better clean things up. Anyway, the short of it is I found a pair of drumsticks under a couch. And the guy goes, hey, man, they're yours. You helped me clean up. And from there, it just sort of like snowballed into me beating on things. And I didn't have a drum set. I had a friend that had a guitar. And the next thing I know, I was like, want to be in a band. So it all started by accident. But here I am a long time later, having recorded and played most of my life. It's pretty exciting. So I wanted to talk about my first experiences in a band. It was the mid-60s, and the British invasion was in full force. And a lot of bands were really kind of like R&B and blues influenced. And at the time, when I had my first pair of drumsticks, I had an older brother that was an aspiring DJ. AM radio was the thing back then. And he would play records in our den, and I would just beat on the couch. And most of the stuff I listened to really was like Motown and R&B. It wasn't rock. I mean, rock by the standard of the day. So my first experiences was really playing rhythm and blues and soul music. But obviously, as a young teenager getting into a band, it was all about being cool and being in the British band type music. So the band I want to talk about today and the song, I think they're kind of overlooked, but they're probably the most pivotal rock band in early rock history. They're a band called the Yardbirds. And what's interesting about this band is they had like the three most famous guitar players, you know, probably to this day. They influenced Jimi Hendrix, Eddie Van Halen. Their first guitar player was Eric Clapton, you've heard of him, Jeff Beck, and then Jimmy Page. And the thing is that the Yardbirds actually morphed into a pretty famous band most people heard of called Led Zeppelin. So this is a band that I listened to as a kid. And when I got my first drum set, all the drummers in town, if they could play Yardbird songs, it separated the men from the boys. So here's the Yardbirds version of a Bo Diddley song called I'm a Man. Let's hear it. By the way, this is the first shuffle I ever learned, and it's almost like a Texas shuffle, both hands. By the way, those triplets were done with both hands. That was a real bitch to play as a kid. This is pretty much straight blues, but they're going to go into something that was more avant-garde and new for the day. Here we go. Just bet crazy. Ah, man. It's funny, a lot of songs in the 60s, I don't know if they copied the Yardbirds or not, but they seem like to go into another time signature, like double time like that. That was pretty funny. Anyway, like I said, that band basically was the precursor for Led Zeppelin. Jimmy Page and Jeff Beck played together in that band at one point. All right, this next song, like I said, I'm self-taught. I was, my mom, after I got my first kit, she said, okay, you got your drums, you're in a band, you're going to learn how to play, you're going to learn how to read music. And I'm glad she cracked the whip. But up until then, I was just playing by ear like a lot of people. And I had no idea that this song was in 3-4. In fact, an interesting story, this song, Manic Depression by Jimi Hendrix Experience, Sammy Hagar and I were in a band together. I won't go into the history, but it was like our first band together. It was called the Big Bang, and we won a battle of the bands playing this song. I was about 18, and the prize was a trophy and a teardrop Vox guitar. I don't know if you know what that is, but it was like a white teardrop. The thing was terrible. The neck was terrible, whatever. Anyway, we went to the music store and traded it in to get some PA gear. But I won a battle, my first battle of bands playing this song. And this would be Gary Moore performing this. And another quick story, if I may, because when I started putting these songs together, I realized that I'd met Gary years ago in San Bernardino. Like a lot of bands in the 60s, the local bands got to open up for the headline bands at a concert. Like how many times have you gone to a concert and the opening band you never heard of, and they play like for 20 minutes or whatever, and then the stars come out. So the local promoter gave us a break, and our first band opened up for Long John Baldry and a band called Skid Row, and it wasn't the Skid Row that we know now. You know, I'm sorry to say this was like 1970. But anyway, short of it is Sammy and I were just sound checking with the rest of our band. I think we were a trio at the time. And it was like, you know, the main band sets up and all the gear's there. And then the second band sets up. And then the opening band's like at the edge of the stage, all cramped, whatever, drum sets falling off the edge. And we were jamming, just kind of fiddled around. This real tall Irish guy comes out, plugs into his Marshall. He had, I'll never forget, he had a chain on with a horseshoe, and I thought, what is this? I guess it's like, you know, the Lucky Irish or whatever, but he looked at us and kind of nodded and going, cool, can we jam? And Sam and I were, you know, we were young, you know, Sam was like 21 years old, I was 18, and we thought, sure, we could hang with this guy. We jammed, and he wore us out. I mean, we had to, like, stop. I'll never forget that, and later, I come to find out. I said, who is this guy? I said, oh, this guy named Gary Moore. And then, you know, obviously, come on, he went on to be a producer, a great songwriter, performer, killing guitarist. Anyway, here's his rendition of one of my favorite Hendrix songs, Manic Depression. Oh, yeah.
love you, babe. Touch you my soul. I know what I want, but I just don't know how to go back in. Feel the sweet feeling drops from my fingers to your head. Let it feel pressure, capture my soul. Your heart so glow, sweet pause in bed. Make love you play love, it's all the same. Music, sweet music, I wish I could caress, caress. Let it do pressure, there's a frustrating mess.
This was Hendrix's signature sound or solo, man. If you heard this type of a solo, you knew it was Hendrix. I also like to point out that this is the first time I ever heard a drummer play triplets with the entire kit. Batu, batu, batu. It's pretty groundbreaking.
Yes, I'll go switch up, give myself down.
All right.
There ain't no much.
Well, it appears we got away with that one. All right. Well, now I'm going to move on to a little later in life for me. The thing is, with a lot of musicians, it's not so much today, but the way you got your chops together and grew was it was kind of like before garage bands, but you actually got to play in nightclubs. And most of the time you had to be 21 because there was alcohol being served. You know, we would get fake IDs, whatever, and try to grow beards. But my first experience playing in a bar was in Riverside, a place called the Gasser. And it was like the hot spot, you know. The funny thing is, it's like it was a beer bar. And I don't know how they got away with this back in the day, but guys had to be 21, but girls could be 18. I mean, come on. Is that discrimination or what? But we understood what the motive was here. Anyway, this bar, this club, had a stage that sat way up in the air in the corner. And outside in the parking lot, there was a stairway that went to the stage. And somehow, I can't remember how, but I played with some older musicians, guys in their 20s. They were old. And they heard that I was a decent little drummer. And they invited me to play, but the only way I could play legally was they snuck me in the back door right up on stage. And this is the very first song I played in a bar with a pretty good band. And Albert King originally did this song. And I knew that because of my brother being the DJ and all that, you know. So when Cream came out with this song, it just blew my mind. I loved how funky it was. It was like, Ginger really funked it up. So let's hear a little of Born Under a Bad Sign. Here comes Ginger. Yeah.
Born under a bad sign. I've been down since I began to crawl. If it wasn't for bad luck, I wouldn't have no luck at all. Bad luck and trouble's my only friend. I've been down ever since I was 10. Born under a bad sign.
up and down since I began to crawl. If it wasn't for bad luck, I wouldn't have no luck at all. No wine and women is all I crave. The big bad woman is gonna carry me to my grave. Born under a bad sign.
I didn't realize it back then, but Ginger was really swinging this. This is not just straight eights. It's got a greasy, almost a New Orleans feel to it. And then Eric, this is an awesome solo on guitar. Oh. Yeah. Really a tip of the hat to Albert King, if you're hip to that. Yeah, man, that song still kicks ass, you know. It's funny, you know, I talk about Albert King writing that. When we were growing up, obviously the British invasion turned us all on to our own music, the black influence, the blues, the rhythm and blues. And as I started to look into, you know, stuff like Cream was basically a blues band at first, as well as the Yardbirds. But there were the three kings. There was B.B. King, Albert King, and Freddie King. None of them are related, but they're all blues guitar players. I thought they were brothers, but it's kind of funny. All right, this next band, and particularly the drummer, not real well known in my opinion. You know, not the Ginger Baker or the Buddy Rich or the Neil Peart or whatever. But this guy, like Neil Peart, unbeknownst to me at the time, was really wrote most of the lyrics for this band. The band's called Traffic. The drummer's name is Jim Capaldi, and he was so funky. And for whatever reason, as a kid, I kind of gravitated toward this guy. I think, you know, maybe being exposed to black music or R&B, a lot of Motown and Stax Volt as a kid before I played, there was something in it I really identified with. And the way he plays fills against this next groove, this is pretty much a straight four Motown groove, you know, four on the snare. But as simple as it sounds, to make it feel good is not as easy as people think. And the way he plays over, it's really interesting. He plays like almost a different subdivision. But anyway, without the technicality, the energy of Jim Capaldi, I just was drawn to. He was kind of like a funky John Bonham, if there's such a thing, funkier than John Bonham. So this song is called Smiling Phases, and a lot of bands have covered this, Blood, Sweat, and Tears, but check out the fills in this, the way he plays over the time. Smiling Phases. Yeah.
Wake up to your mind. Life is what you make it. You see, but still your mind. Get yourself together. Get up before you take. You're flying down the highway. Soon up on the rain. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'll let you wait. Yeah. So funky, so aggressive. Yeah.
When you're in a pit, someone gets to pay off the
It's funny, you know, as a kid, some of the first beats I learned beating on the couch was either 2 and 4, obviously, and then that straight 4 thing, listening to those Motown records. And it's kind of like a time and place. It's tricky to know when to play that kind of groove. I mean, maybe it seems obvious, but it's kind of like a march in a way. And the way he plays fills over it, and you can tell that he's really feeling this from a lot of different places. And a little tip of the hat to Jim Capaldi is like, there's a song that I recorded with Sammy called Eagles Fly, and we would refer to the middle section. I'd say, hey, I'm gonna do that Jim Capaldi groove. And he'd go, yeah, that's cool. And it was like, we'd go back, 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 whatever. So anyway, rest his soul, he was one badass. Speaking of funky, here it comes. Anyway, so like I said, hitting that couch or starting playing drums, the first thing you got to learn is 2 and 4. If you can't play the backbeat, you're not getting the gig. And when I started to discover the Godfather of Soul, I got to tell you this. I may be digressing, but Sandy and I, we were in a band called the Justice Brothers, and we actually did a James Brown medley. We did Hot Pants, Cold Sweat, and Super Bad. And it was bad. We had a good band. And you had to play dance music to work in the 70s. But anyway, I started listening to James Brown and started realizing that this stuff was really grooving, but the 2 and 4 wasn't evident. He wasn't just going do-do-bap, do-do-bap. He was displacing that snare drum on the backbeat. And I was like, man, this is bad. So I think the first song that really kind of turned me on that was Cold Sweat. But this particular song is the epitome of Clyde Stubblefield doing that thing that's like moving around the rhythm, but still grooving hard. And this is I Got the Feeling, and this is probably my favorite James Brown song, Killin'.
Feeling. Baby, I got the feeling. You don't know what did you do to me.
Yeah.
Deep heart, heavy, down in misery.
Stubblefield took grace notes on the snare drum to a new level on this. because you know Dan Garibaldi was checking this out. Probably there's so many songs when they asked me to do this, said, are you going to pick five songs? And I thought, how can I pick five songs? But I thought, why not? You know, I try to start out with what influenced me as a young player, and it actually came pretty easy, you know, like this is cool. But definitely came full circle from listening to Motown as a kid and then the James Brown thing. So hope you enjoyed it. I sure did. I hope to do this again. I got some more stuff up my sleeve, some stuff that people probably aren't hip to anyway. So that's it, brothers and sisters and drummers. Love you. Peace. Rock on.